This question, I'll classify it as a 600 to 650 level GMAT question. A question from standard deviation in GMAT is more likely to be like this one than the last one that we solved. What is the difference? In the last question, we had to actually compute the value of standard deviation, and that made the question a little bit tedious, right? So good chance in GMAT, you're not likely to be computing the standard deviation. It's not that GMAT will not ask you to compute the standard deviation, but there's a high probability that they'll ask you to work with understanding how standard deviation works rather than computing the value of it. Let's get started with this question. The distribution of observations in a data set is symmetric about the mean. If 54% of the observations lie within one standard deviation d of the mean, what percentage of the observations are greater than mean minus deviation? There's absolutely zero calculation other than one bit of addition we'll be doing. It's understanding what each of these words, each of these sentences actually mean. Let's decode it and get about solving this question. The first thing is it says the distribution is symmetric about the mean. What do we mean by symmetric about the mean? Half the data points are less than or equal to the mean, and another half the data points are greater than or equal to the mean. So 50% of the observations will be mean or greater than the mean. Another 50% of the observations will be less than or equal to the mean. There's a second part to it, which essentially is the distribution of the observations up to the mean is mirrored beyond the mean. Let's say, for example, it is a bell-shaped curve up to bell-shaped curve. The observation, the way the distribution is distributed up to the mean, it is mirrored beyond it. Need not be a bell-shaped curve. It could be something like this, right? The observation up to the mean is this way. So observation pattern beyond the mean is going to be a reflection of it. That's what symmetric about the mean is all about. The crux is, it's 50-50 on either side, and it's mirrored, with the mirror being your mean. So move on to the second one. The second part of the data states that 54% of the observations lie within one standard deviation of the mean. One standard deviation of the mean are terms that lie between mean minus deviation and mean plus deviation. So it mentions that 54% of the observations that we have lie between mean minus deviation and mean plus deviation. Let's put this information and this together. So what we have is between mean minus deviation and mean, because it is symmetric about the mean, of the 54%, 27% will lie in this part and another 27% will lie here. We know that 54% lie within one standard deviation of the mean. If it is symmetric about the mean, the distribution pattern up to the mean will be mirrored beyond the mean. So that 54 that we had is going to be equally distributed as 27 to the left of the mean, which is between mean minus deviation and mean. Another 27 between mean and mean plus deviation. Lastly, what do we have to find out? Having plotted all of this information, we need to find out what percent of the observations are greater than mean minus deviation. From this point forward, what percent of the observations are there? From mean, from this point forward, we know we have 50% of the observations. Whereas we need to compute from mean minus deviation onwards. Mean minus deviation to mean, we know we have 27% of the distribution. So together, how many do we have? 27 plus 50, 77% of the observations are greater than mean minus deviation. How many percentage are greater than mean minus deviation? It's a sum of two parts. The first part is observations between mean minus deviation and mean. That's part one. And the percentage of distribution which are greater than mean. This is a 27, this part is a 50, adding up to a 77. So this is how most questions are going to be. It's like trying to find out, have you got this idea behind what do we mean by symmetric about the mean? And do you know what it means that so much percentage of the data points lie within one standard deviation of the mean? That is what is tested in this question. Check out the related videos and remember to subscribe to the channel. What's more, let's make scoring Q51 GMAT a reality. Sign up for the most comprehensive and affordable online GMAT quant course at gmat.visaco.com. That's again gmat.visaco.com.